Thank you very much, and now let's get to the news!
Stop the music! It's time for news!
Everything you ever want to know about drones in the newsroom. It's Jeff Sales. What's happening, sir? Tell us all about it.
Hey, happy Thanksgiving to everybody, and I hope you guys have all gotten yourselves good and stuffed.
Yes, indeed.
All right, so we'll start with some footage from the campfire. It's being called the campfire in Butte, Colorado.
Ugh, this is horrible.
Yeah, this fire was fairly decimated the area pretty severely.
Gosh,
there is wow. Not much left standing.
The McDonald's survived. That's really a shame.
Well, no, that's the sign survived, but yeah. I mean, just imagine everybody, all these people's lives permanently changed.
Yeah.
Forever. That's.
But I've heard there's been some great people, especially coming together for Thanksgiving, donating food, donating drinks, putting on a whole feast for people there. It's a small consolation, but I feel like sometimes these kind of things actually help our country and, you know, people come together a little bit. So hopefully that's a silver lining.
Absolutely. This is a chance for the community to be galvanized and get...
Wow. And there's nothing. I mean, you just look at those plots. It isn't even like
and
you
watch.
Know,
look at this. Look at this. Fine. Cross the street. Not fine.
Wow.
Yeah.
It's like the street was a fire break. It's very sad to see.
Yeah. That's
all right. So the next story that we have are some upset residents who apparently they've got a drone video that captured a delivery driver hurling packages.
Oh, yes. This is bad.
Armed with his drone, John Askin says his trip home for the holidays helped solve a neighborhood mystery.
We're finding packages by the road all over the neighborhood.
His father, Terry Brown, says the drone was up and going when this Amazon van pulled into his driveway.
Shot put it. She just heaved it out of the car is what it looked like.
And when the intended Christmas present didn't quite make it far enough up the driveway.
She got out, grabbed the package again, walked up another 5 or 6 feet and threw it again.
The delivery woman calling it good, leaving the package where it landed, directly behind a vehicle. Their neighbors getting similar service.
At the next house, she got up, ran towards the door and then flung the package. And at the third house, didn't even bother getting out of the van and just launched the package from the door.
Oh, that is so crazy. Mavic 2 Pro, no!
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Now, within the last 5 minutes, we did hear from Amazon in a statement to us. They said this does not represent the standards we have for our delivery service partners. We expect every package to be handled with care. We will address this with our delivery partners and work with our customers directly to make things right.
Wow. I would be so angry, man.
Maybe she's just planning for drone delivery where they'll have to endure a little bit of, you know, dropping or something like that. She's just ahead of the curve on that. Maybe that's what it was.
Oh, yeah, yeah. We'll give her the benefit of the doubt.
It's bad enough that you have to deal with porch pirates. Then to have to sit there and deal with the people delivering it, damaging it, it's just adds insult to injury.
Porch pirates.
So actually, I will tell you, I know my DHL driver. We're on a first name basis.
Me too.
He is actually a fan of this show, and he is awesome. He will text me before it's coming, tell me what it is, and tell me where, you know, I'll tell him where to put it if it's something I have to sign for, whatever. So I have to say, this woman was giving delivery drivers a bad name because my DHL driver is amazing.
You know what? DHL and FedEx are really good about contacting the delivery person. And have you noticed that most of the stuff that comes from China comes from DHL? Have you noticed that?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Yes, we actually have a special pair of scissors that we use to open those boxes because my wife is afraid of all the stuff that will come over from China. So she's like, you use these scissors. These are the sane scissors. These are the insane scissors.
And they always use like 2 inches thick of tape. It's hermetically sealed. Anyway, moving on.
They recycle their boxes.
What's the next story, Jeff? This is pretty amazing video.
So the FAA has, you know, introduced the LANCE system. If you guys aren't familiar with that, that's the authorization system that automatically gives you rights to be able to fly in certain areas that normally you wouldn't have those rights to fly in if you're a Part 107 holder. Since the inception of the plan and the 500 airports that it's now access to, over 50,000 applications have been processed.
That's a lot.
Yeah. That is a lot of requests. And those requests are all over the United States. So it's a very interesting volume that is indicative of how the market is I guess, growing, that business that we love so much.
Have you dealt with that at all, Kelly?
Well, the old waiver system, no, but the old waiver system was so slow and so terrible that I think an improvement is needed. And so, you know, that's something that it seems like if you're a known quantity, if you're Part 107, if you, you know, and especially if the mission that you're flying is something that is reasonable, then it makes sense to be able to expedite it.
Yeah, hopefully these things will become easier as we go on.
And if anybody's not familiar with it, if you have the AirMap app and you're a 107 holder and you're at a location, that's what you can use to request your Lance authorization.
Nice.
Okay, so on the flip side for the not acceptable flying, Yellowstone National Park, the officials there are investigating a photograph that was posted online showing one of the park's geothermal features that was taken from a drone, which is illegal.
Yeah.
They are hunting for this particular individual, and they will prosecute him to the full extent of the law, which is 6 months in jail and a $5,000 fine.
Wow.
Yeah, they're not going to fool around at Yellowstone. I've heard many stories that, that it is absolute zero tolerance for drones there.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So, well, and the thing is that photo, can you go back to the photo for a second? It doesn't even really take advantage of a drone. I mean, it's, you
well,
know what I mean?
I don't think this is the photo. This is just a stock photo of this isn't the photo. I think I would go to jail for showing the photo.
Yeah. So. they're not letting the photo.
I was going to say, if you're gonna break the law and use a drone to take a photo, at least take a photo that looks like it was taken from a drone.
Right, or take video. And if you're going to break the law, then, man, go through, Old Faithful. Fly through the mist. Don't do that. Please don't do that.
Make it a durability test.
Yeah, just don't do that.
Okay, so this next story is dedicated to Kelly.
Oh, thank you.
Well, Kelly Green. Let me stress to that. Unfortunately, the pilot of a GoPro Karma misjudged the trajectory.
Is this a Karma? This is so awesome. Great, man. Check it out.
Yeah, this was...
Whoopsie.
Well, and it's almost like he flew into him. Like he could have, he was already out of the way, and then he strafed left and boom.
Yeah, it did. Well, that's an inexperienced pilot doesn't know he was trying to go the other way, clearly.
Yeah.
So the gentleman on the bike was Brennick Presley, 22. He was actually injured by the drone with some cuts to his shoulder. The drone itself was completely destroyed.
And I assume that the motorcycle rider knew he was being filmed. I mean, this was part of a setup shot, right? So it wasn't like he was suddenly surprised by, whoa, what is that?
My goal was to film a massive jump, and it failed miserably.
Mm. Yeah. Mm. Wow.
Okay, so moving forward with the news, we have the Fox News Channel has decided that they want to, I guess, toot their own horn and let people know about how integral they have been in assisting with crash investigations.
Cell phone video from a Canton police officer shows the scene of a fatal chain reaction crash on an icy Route 30 Thursday from his perspective.
In this case, we weren't able to catch the entire scene in one photograph that would be close up.
Canton's police department, part of a metro crash team that includes Massillon, North Canton, the Stark County Sheriff's Office, and others, that has just received nearly $100,000 worth of high-tech equipment from the state. What the state grant could not provide for them is a drone like Fox 8.
By using your drone, you know, we're hoping to get a better eye view of our actual crash scene.
At their request, Fox 8 providing investigators drone Fox video that captures in just a few minutes an image of the fatal crash scene from perspective that police can mesh with their own very detailed information.
Did he call it drone?
We can't do
Fox
this without
footage?
A drone or helicopter. There's no way to do that, but there's almost no better view than a bird's eye view of a crash scene.
Fox 8 willing to help with their important investigation to help make sure the final report will be as accurate as technologically possible.
Go us.
We always enjoy having another partner who has access to technology that we don't. So anytime we can work with the news media, we like to. And we appreciate the help.
Yeah, they call it the Fox 8 drone. Oh, wait. I'm being told we have breaking news. This just in. Fox 8 is awesome. You suck. We're awesome. Back to you.
Yeah, I bet you that police department's going to be getting a drone real fast.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. So the next story is courtesy of our bud Greg. Greg Kuhnert with Oz by Drone, who's provided this one. A bloke, as the title says, was fined 460 pounds after his drone screwed up a police chopper search for a missing woman.
Mm.
This was from the UK, and he was flying a Phantom 4, decided to fly underneath the police helicopter.
Ouch.
And then as the police department was trying to localize who he was, the man flew his drone back to his house. The police followed the drone. They went to the man's house, and when they tried to enter the house, he wouldn't let them in. When they finally forced their way in, they found the drone hidden in the ceiling of the bathroom.
Everybody hides stuff in the ceiling. Dummies.
Wait, I know. I'll put it in the ceiling.
Wait, this was in England or Australia?
No, this was in the UK. This was, this was in Cambridgeshire.
Because you know in Australia, that's a didgeridoo.
Hey! There you go. That's a good one. Hold on. Stand by. Okay. Say the joke again now.
In Australia, that's a didgeridoo, mate.
Ha! Now go eat your Vegemite. Yeah.
This is a phone.
That's not a phone.
This is a phone!
You know, because it has to be bigger.
Yeah, okay, yeah. I got you.
Anyway.
Oh, yeah, you guys are going to have way too much fun this evening.
All right.
Okay, so the last story is courtesy of Mr. Steele.
Oh, Mr. Steele. This is awesome. Got special permission from him to show this footage. What do you know about it, Jeff?
Well, okay, so he went to a, I guess it's one of these drifting rallies.
Yeah.
And was filming, and basically, for lack of better words, got the most amazing footage I have ever seen of these drifting cars.
Look at that.
Well, the drone is drifting too. I mean, it's doing the same kind of motion.
Right. The car is doing freestyle, and Mr. Steele's doing freestyle.
Yeah, the talent and skill that he shows in this is just insane. I mean, you can see the driver in the window. It's amazing.
Does he fly in one window and out the other? Now that my jaw would be on the floor.
Did you guys see the clip? And I think maybe Dana posted it, or Ken, maybe you posted it, I don't remember, on Instagram, of a drone flying under a catamaran.
Yes, I saw that today.
Yeah. That was pretty insane.
Yeah. And you know what? I don't have a lot of experience with the race drones, but from what little I've flown, I think that if I practice enough, I might be able to fly, not like this, but close to it. I have that kind of confidence.
You should just do your Inspire like this.
Yeah, that's what I'll do. I'll definitely do that. For sure. I'm on that.
Yeah. I've got room over here on the shelf for it when you're done. Just want to let you know.
Fix it for him.
Yeah, on the old rebuild shelf. Yeah.
The rehab shelf. So real quick on racing drones, about a week and a half ago, 2 weeks ago, and I haven't published it yet, I had the chance to interview Paul Nurkala. Do you guys know who Paul Nurkala is?
No.
Anybody in the chat? I'm sure you guys do. Paul is Nurk from the Drone Racing League. He won the DRL this year. And he is – I've started following him on Instagram and on YouTube. And he does these kind of videos all the time where he flies through just these tiny little spots and does these totally, you know – choreographed maneuvers. He's amazing and a really, really nice guy. As a matter of fact, Ken, I should see if we could get him on your show. He'd be a great guy to
I would love that. I gotta be honest.
Like the Ken Block of drone racing.
I gotta be honest. I gotta be up front. Me and Jeff were talking about this just before we started streaming. Race drones. I want to fly race drones. The only sticking point with me is I have this really complicated charger, and I don't know how to use it. I don't know how to charge the battery.
Is it a Tenergy?
I took a picture of it. Are you? Because I really want somebody to help me. I will make a video with someone if you live near me.
So I'll tell you what, Ken. When you're here, I probably have a similar one. It's for LiPo batteries, right?
I don't know. I don't want to overcharge them. I just need to know how to charge the battery. Then I'm good.
It's really simple. You set the milliamp hours, and then you set the number of cells.
That's all I need to know. And I know Ed Ricker, who's going to be on this show next week, he's going to be at Spin Up, and I'm sure I can get some information. But it's so frustrating because I'm like, hey, you know what? It's a nice day. I think I'll fly my race drone, practice a little bit. I don't know how to charge a battery because I'm a stupid schmuck.
No, it's just a matter of setting the right milliamp hours and setting the right number of cells.
Please, someone show me, please.
But here's the thing, Ken. I will show you that, and then you, while you're here, every time I've tried to use Wirecast with Skype, I've had bad luck. So you're going to have to show me a little Wirecast Skype ninja stuff.
Done, my friend. Done. And I don't want to let it get too far away. I am Wedge, $20 super chat. Yes! Thank you so much. Happy Thanksgiving, he says. I didn't have turkey. I ate squab. I don't know what that is. It sounds gross, but happy Thanksgiving to you. And also, Canadian drone guy, $13.99. Super chat, thank you so much, and that's Canadian money, so you know it's better.
And you know they had Canadian Thanksgiving last week.
Oh, did they?
They drink some old Elsinore, and they wear a toque.
And they go in there. What do they call it? The garage. They go in their garage.
Garage.
No, they say garage. They go in their garage, and they just go sorry. I'm in my garage. Love you guys. Love the Canadians. Jeff, thank you so much.
Wait a minute. You had one more topic that you wanted to cover today. You wanted to talk to the new DJI Osmo Mini.
Ooh.
Osmo Mini? Oh,
out on the 28th?
The Osmo Pocket. Yes, this thing. This is a breakdown of kind of what it is. And then, of course, there's this image here. And I know people who are good buddies with DJI who can't talk about this thing, who probably has one already somewhere in their house. And somebody who loves DJI and is not authorized to talk about it until after the 28th. Kelly. That's so he probably knows a little bit more than I do. And he probably has seen a better image of this, perhaps in three dimensions. Son of a gun. I hate you so much.
Tells me he's not going to say a single word.
Can you expand on that, Kelly? And go. Anyway, so it's called...
Available next week.
Yeah, right. It's called the Osmo Pocket Full Motion Handheld Gimbal. 4K, 60 frames a second video. Thumb control. It's got a little monitor on it. Of course, you can see on here, it's got the Apple Lightning thing and Wi-Fi, Bluetooth enabled, perks coffee, predicts earthquakes, and it'll give you a foot massage. It's going to be awesome. So thank you so much, Jeff, for being on. Now, please check out Jeff's channel because he's going to very soon have a video about the now completed Phantom 4 Pro that was once destined for the dumpster and now is back in the sky. Isn't that right, sir?
We've already put the video up for the completed drone, and we've also done one video showing the flight of the drone. So, it's great. I had it out today, was flying out at the oil ranch. It performed beautifully. Takes beautiful images.
Very good.
So we're already starting to work on the next project, which will take another 2 months or more.
Okay. Well, check out the drone wiki page. Link in the description.
Jeff's link in the description. There's a ton of stuff there, guys, that doesn't make the cut.
Okay. Talk to you later, and bye, sir.
Take care.
Thanks for stopping by. Now get out.
All right. Well, he's gone.